guys, welcome back to another episode of Sleeping Giants, Red Star Belgrade. Now, in our last episode, it's weird, like, the way things have gone is almost kind of flipped. If you remember back in the early part of the season, I was winning all the live comms, but then we were dropping useless points in the off-camera games, which was very, very irritating. Now it just seems to have flipped. I'm winning a lot of the games off-camera, but now I can't seem to win the games that we do on-camera. It's very, very frustrating. We're not losing them either. Last game we lost was this game against Borac in October, and as you can see, obviously we had those friendly defeats, but that's not really the same kind of thing. So yeah, but we had that draw against Vojvodina, which was just crap for me. And then, of course, we had the draw against Jagodina, which frustrated me a little bit, frankly. But they're a good side, and they're having a great season. So for us to get a point there, we should have beaten them at home. We should have beaten them away early in the season. That was a ridiculous result in that game, too. I couldn't believe it. When they scored 3 goals in the last 7 minutes to win. Yeah, that was ridiculous. But we've had the youth intake, which I'll be talking about right now. In fact, we're going to jump straight in. There's 2 players that I'm sort of interested in. Obviously, we're a bit further along, so I can't show you the youth intake team list as far as I can. No, I can't. But what I can do is show you the 2 players that I'm massively excited about. And they are, where are they? First one up is this guy. This is Nikola Jaksic, or Jaksic, whose profile will eventually load. Here we go. I have signed them both on to full contracts the moment I saw them, because I wasn't having any kind of Luka Jovic problems this time around. Oh, no. Not having that kind of crap again. I snapped them up the moment I saw them. So this is the first one. This is Nikola Jaksic, or Jaksic. We'll just do this for now. He's got some pretty decent stats for a 16-year-old. I've got to say, I'm pretty pleased with him. He's got a decent amount of potential. I think he could be okay. You know, he's only the second best one. The other one is one I'm much, much more pleased about. And I think he could be great. But if you look, I mean, okay, his anticipation isn't brilliant. But looking at some of his standout stats. So work rate is high. Tackling and marking aren't bad considering his age. Determination is high as well, which is good to see. His teamwork isn't bad. Natural fitness is good. Balance, stamina. Bravery as well. He's very, very brave. So that's good. So I'm pretty pleased with Nikola Jaksic. The one I'm really, really excited about, though, is this lad. This is Ljubisa Tufejcic. Correct me if I'm wrong on that one, because that is a tough-ass name to say. But I'm guessing it's Ljubisa Tufejcic. Sorry, apologies. It's a tough one. But as tough as his name is to say, it's going to be great to scream that when he scores some goals for us. Also, he's 16 years old, and he has a beard like he could be in Game of Thrones. And that, to me, is a sign of a good player. Like, if this was Harry Potter, he would play for that school with all the people like Viktor Krum and that, the big bearded Bulgarians. Of course, that's Bulgarians, not Serbians, I know. But still, he has got a proper Slavic beard, and I like that. Also, 65k value is pretty damn good. Of course, he is once again on a contract with us, so we are not going to be losing him. Or if we are, it's going to be for a big amount of moolah. We've got the leverage on that one. They don't just have to pay us compensation. They actually have to pay us big dollar, and I'm determined not to let that happen anyway. So here we go. Advanced playmaker. Well, what is his best role, according to my assistant? Let's just see. Advanced playmaker support. So what we got here? 17 passing at 16 years old. Oh, massively happy with that. First touch is 14, which ain't bad either. Decisions, 11. Composure, 10. Okay, flair could do with a little bit of boost. But leadership on off the ball, 14 to 15. In fact, they've already gone up. That's unreal. Teamwork and vision, of course, not bad either. Decent natural fitness too. Balance is good. Stamina is getting there as well. He's got decent dribbling. His finishing isn't bad. He's just a good all-round player. Long throws, terrible. Doesn't matter. Not going to use him for that. He's not very brave, so we may have to work on that one quite a bit. But I think he has a lot of potential. You know, Luka who? Like, this guy. This guy. Happy. This is what I mean about our youth academy. We can bring players through like Ljubisa Tufejcic. I'm massively happy with him. Obviously, he's not going to be ready for the first team just yet, but he's got a lot of quality. And if he continues to develop the way he is already looking like, he could be an unbelievable player for that sort of attacking midfield role, which we now have, of course, got. We've stopped playing the Ongonch. We now have an attacking midfielder kind of thing, which I've got to tell you, Savicevic has been absolutely bloody loving this month. So yeah, that's that, basically. That is what we got from our youth intake. Massively happy. And if you look, my coaches actually rank him higher on potential than Jovic. Obviously, his ability is lower, but yeah. So again, crazy happy with that. very, very pleased with that. So let's get back into the schedule so we can take a look at the games we've had this month. I'm pleased with the way things have gone. In our first game, we were away at Mladost, and they're not the best side. And I was persisting with the attacking midfielder, because I know that, like, I've been using the Ongonch, and it was kind of working, I guess, but in our live call, I decided to persist with it, and it came up trumps for us. Vukan Savicevic is great. He and Despotovic have this lovely little partnership. Basically, for the first goal, Savicevic dropped the ball in to Despotovic, who then did a lovely little reverse back heel straight into his path, and bang, bottom corner. Great goal from Savicevic. Really, really pleased with him, and he is developing gloriously at the moment. His stats are going through the roof. Also, he's just lovely stuff. So enjoying having him on the team, that is for sure. Then, a couple of minutes later, Georgi Despotovic got one of his own and made it a lovely 2-0 to us. And there was a penalty, I think, in the second half for Adama. Yeah, in fact, it was very, very late on. They would not have deserved... I thought it was about to be bullshit time again, because they were nowhere near this game, really, when you look at the stats. I had a few half chances, but I think we were definitely the better team in this one and deserved the win. And it was good to pick that up and keep a clean sheet, most importantly. So that gave us another win. In our next game, I think we had the cup game. Yes, we did. We had the cup game against Radnicki. And we were 2-0 up from the first leg. So basically, all we had to do here was really not lose by two goals. So I played a slightly weaker side. Not because I wanted to play a weaker team, but because we needed to rest players for our game against Spartak at the weekend, which is why you see the likes of Strakulursi starting, and Avramovsky, Pavicevic came in and played defensive midfield for this one, and Petkovic, of course. A little bit different. But when Vladimir Milenkovic, he got in a couple of times for them. Thankfully, two of them were disallowed for offside, rightly so. But I was worried, and then eventually he did manage to break the back line. Thankfully, in their sort of hurried nature to try and get that second goal, first Despotovic and then Alexander Katai nicked two goals and actually won us the game and, of course, the tie by 4-1. So it was a great day for all. Katai there with... He's good now that he's back from injury. He's not the best player, but he does a good job for us, and that is what I'm really liking. He's got some decent stats, really, and I'm happy with him. He does a decent job, and it stops me having to play Gavrich all the time on his sort of weakened foot. Like, if I was to put Gavrich in there, I might even switch him to an inside forward so we can cut inside on his stronger foot, basically. Like an Iron Robin or Frank Ribery type of player. Not really done much experiment with inside forwards. It might be something I'll look at in a different save where we've got the players that can really do that kind of thing. And in our last game of the month, the game that we were resting players for against Spartak at home, we were brilliant. This is the kind of play that I'd like to see more of. We were so good in this game and just completely blew them out of the water, and that's what we need more of. So Darko Lazovic put us in front early on, and it was great to see Lazovic actually be playing, be fit, and not getting injured as well, and actually proving that he's a quality player. And I think he's had quite a few... He's been injured most of the season, so that's a shame to see that sort of stuff go down, but he's still got a bit of room maybe to improve. He's still only 24, worth £1.2 million as well, which is kind of key. Also, I noticed in the, my board confidence update came through, and they were basically saying that the fans were actually happy, like, that me getting rid of Rajkovic was a very popular decision. So I'll take that, frankly. And it got us a lot of money, and that's what we need at this stage, basically. You know, we're building the club from the inside out, and sometimes you do have to sell to, you know, you've got to speculate to accumulate, so to speak. And that's what we've basically been doing. Georgi Evelia made it 1-1 on 22 minutes, and that was disappointing. They had so few chances in this game. I was really angry when this happened. I thought, it's about to go down. Thankfully, Georgi, he is my hero. Scored a hat trick. He was phenomenal from that point onwards, basically. Like, he put us back in front not long after that, which was great to see, obviously. Then after Petrovic was sent off, I thought, right, we're good now. And he was able to pick off two more goals in the 69th minute and I believe in the 83rd minute, yeah. Actually, I'm just going to show you the stats for the game just to show you how dominant we were in this one. We just all over the place. 4 clear-cut chances, 5 half chances. They had the 1 half chance, and that was their goal. And we were so, so good. And that's what we need to see more of. Play like that. Play like that more often and I will be absolutely thrilled with you. And as you can see, Despotovic, look at that. 19 goals in 18 appearances. 18 starts. Bloody brilliant. And 15 in 16 starts in the league as well. He's just been so good for us. Phenomenal player. And all of that, basically, with the results going elsewhere for us, leaves the league looking a bit like this. We're joint top now. But unfortunately, I believe it's done head-to-head in Serbia because our goal difference is better than Jagodina's. But unfortunately, they drew away at us and then they beat us in that horrible piss-take of a game earlier in the season. So we really do need to finish above them. Then underneath, Kukuriki have kind of had a bit of a resurgence. But Partizan have now slipped down to fourth and they very nearly lost their last game as well. I think they ended up winning it in the end. But they were actually a goal behind against Vozdovac in that game and came back, so they could have been even further behind. You'll also notice that Donji Srem have completely slipped off the pace now. Rad, Borac, and Vojvodina have all overtaken them. Now, I'm not out of my breath, but we're looking a lot better now. We have the top scorer in the league in Despotovic now with 15 goals, and Vukan Zavisevic is by far the best average rating. Look at that, 7.78. I think he's really taking well to that new role he's playing in, and I just think we can keep on winning games. However, it is going to be massively tough for us today because we are away at Partizan Belgrade, and I've got to tell you guys, I feel like if we beat Partizan today away, firstly, that's amazing. And secondly, I think that basically means we're going to finish above them because we'll be 4 points clear then and without having to play them again. I just don't know where they're going to catch those points up on us because of how well we're playing. The main worry for me is that we're going to have to try and overtake Jagodina at some point. And they're having a lovely old time of pretty much winning every game. They're really a surprise package. I don't know where they were expected to finish this season. Let's just see. I assume it was quite high up they were expected to finish. So they were expected to finish fifth, interestingly. And they are certainly performing above expectations, shall we say. So well done to them for that. Massive well done to them for that. And also Napredic were expected to finish bottom. And look at that, up in ninth place. We're pretty much exactly where we're expected to be. But I don't know, I just feel like maybe in the next couple of games, if we can keep winning and they will drop a point at some point that we can just sneak through, because I really want to win the league. And obviously we're in the cup final too. And in the cup final, we will also be playing Jagodina. They knocked out Partizan in the semi-finals, which means that we've got, it's basically us versus Jagodina. Although I can't take away from the teams like Kukuriki and Partizan because they could easily still pull some stunt, or not even pull some stunt, a win for Partizan today throws them right back up into the mix and they could easily still go. It's very, very tight at the top. 1 point separates the top four. 8 games to go. Let's see what we can do. Now, let's just take a look at the squad so I can show you the other things. Top goal scorer for us, of course, 19 goals for Despotovic. I would like to see 25 out of him. That would be amazing. And then there's a lot of people with 6, basically. He has been the main sort of fulcrum of our attacking threat. Assists-wise, though, Savicevic and Gavric with 12 and 10, which is not bad. Savicevic from that attacking midfield role has been just creating so, so much, and it's been fantastic to watch. Player of the match, of course, he has 5 as well, which is awesome. Pass rating, Kovacevic actually has an 87, which is great. Of course, we've still got lots of injuries at the moment, but we're getting better. We're just lacking, like Gojic, I would like to have back. And our first choice keeper would also be a great one to have back. As for red cards, just the two with Lazic and Planic. Average rating, of course, as you can see, Savicevic there. He's got a lower rating there than he does in the average league one. That's because he's had some little bit poorer cup performances, basically, and that is the only reason for it. So, yeah, guys. Right, we're going to get into today's game now. Oh shit, back in a sec. Right guys, we're back, sorry about that. Some things you just cannot avoid. Right, okay, let's get into this then. Let's get into the team selection. Let's do a quick bit to get rid of some injuries. Antic. I do actually want to start playing Antic more there because he is going to be amazing. I think he has got more potential and room to grow potentially than some of the others. Like, he's got a little bit more on top and I think I want to start playing him a bit more anyway. Despotovic, you cannot not play him with the way he's been playing lately. Lazovic, Petkovic, who have we got on the bench as well? So injuries that we've still got, Gojic and Jovic there. As for our goalkeeper, I'm fairly certain. Oh yeah, Karaman isn't quite fit yet, but I think very soon he will be back, maybe within, depends, because we've got quite a few games coming up, so maybe within the next 2 or 3 he will be back playing for us, which is good, because as all right as Marco Trukulia has been, he made a mistake at the end of that game, which cost us the 3 points, frankly. Right, let's get straight into this and see if we can't do something special against Partizan. We are going to be looking at defensive positioning for this game. I'm going to use our standard tactic because this works so well for us. Obviously, they're a better side than a lot of the teams we've been playing against, so we're going to have to try and fight fire with fire, so to speak. But I'm prepared to do that. Let's go for this then. I need to talk to Mom Slimovic. There we go. And here we go. I would take a draw because it is away at Partizan, but I would much prefer to try and win this one. That would be something else. If we could come here and win away at Partizan Belgrade in the Belgrade Derby, then that's about perfect, really. You pretty much, you could eat for free in any restaurant in the right part of Belgrade, I think, with that kind of result. Let's hope that we can pull something special off for the fans and give ourselves a real hope of winning this title. Oh dear, Lazovic is already through here. There was a real bullshit moment for Spartak's goal in the last game. I completely forgot about this, basically. Long ball played over the top. Our keeper runs all the way out, but runs completely past the player and the ball, and he's able to put it into an empty net. I hate that kind of crap. Partizan have started well here, I have to tell you. They've had all the running in the first 12 minutes. We've not even had a shot yet, but we've not conceded. And we're getting a bit, I don't know. We'll have to see. Like, I might start changing some stuff up if things don't look like they're going to work. Despotovic, Keitai, 1-0. Partizan 0, Red Star Belgrade 1. That is more like it, lads. Oh, yes. Also, you'll notice that 3D kits are back and the stadiums are looking... Everything just looks a lot bit nicer in the match engine. That is lovely to see. But what the most lovely thing to see is this. Savicevic's ball through for Despotovic. There's a lovely little lay on here. And Keitai in the bottom corner. Partizan 0, Red Star 1. Our first and only shot of the game thus far has resulted in us leading 1-0. Oh, we're good from set pieces here. Ball whips out for Keitai again. What's he got up his sleeve? Knocks it short for Savicevic. Will he have a pop? Despotovic! Blocked, and the ball is eventually cleared. That is better play. I gotta tell you, like, it's... Please win the ball. I'm not sure what's going on here, but the point is we're leading, and we maybe should have had a second there. But we'll take it at the moment. We're winning the game. We've created the two, probably the two best chances, or they did have that one which they put over the bar. So maybe we're starting to come back into this one a little bit. We're being a lot more accurate with our shooting, that's what I would say. Like, they've had six shots, but they've only actually hit the target with one of them. And that wasn't even... Oh, great. Huge space is now about to open up. I would think somebody mark up. Please don't let him just knock it into him. Please don't concede a penalty either. That's surely a goal. What a save. Well done, son. And we're riding our luck a little bit in the early stages here, but we are winning the game, and that is key for us. And, well, you've got to say it's actually been quite even. They've had more shots, but they've not hit the target as much as us. We're being a little bit more picky about our shooting, and it seems to be working for us at the moment. I'm tempted to go pass into space soon, just because we are actually winning this game and we're away from home. That means we're going to be having to soak up the pressure a little bit at some point. So maybe for the second half, we'll go pass into space, because they're obviously going to leave gaps in this second half. Oh, I just want to get in a half-time a goal up. Please don't let them score before half-time. That would completely ruin my plan. He's going to score. Somebody close him down. Oh, God. And that's 1-1. I mean, it's a tough game. Away at Partizan, they're probably the best team in the league, with the exception to us, basically. But I just wish someone would have got out to Drinčić a little bit quicker. It's a great hit, and the keeper's got no chance with that kind of goal. But maybe we will still go to pass into space in the second half, because I would take a draw here. I would rather win, but I'd rather catch them on the counter-attack. Not that we're playing counter-attack, but you know what I mean, in this second half. So maybe passing into space might not be such a bad idea. I do still like working the ball into the box, though. Maybe turn off hit early crosses and maybe look for the overlap a little bit more. This could be a horrible decision, lads, but sometimes you just have to make them. We do look a lot better. I still think that we're looking better than we have done in previous games. Against even, you know, we've played worse against much worse sides. That's what I mean. Like, today we're actually playing quite well and being quite clinical against arguably equally, maybe even better, I don't know, one of the best sides in this league, basically. And that's good to see. Here we go. Antic. Is that a penalty? I don't know what happened there, but I think that Keitai has just won us a penalty. I didn't see anything particular there, but there was a bit of a kerfuffle down in the corner of the penalty area. So, oh, come on. I don't know who's taking this, because it seems to rotate all the time, and that's annoying. I have set penalty takers, but for some reason the game just seems to ignore them half the time. Who is it? Basančić. Go on. Oh, he's missed it. Well done, Lazovic. I'm glad you made a little run there, because, you know, it's not like we missed a penalty or anything. Have you ever seen anyone actually score from a rebound on a penalty before? Because I've never seen it. The defenders always get it. Even if your players are right there, they just go so slowly to allow the defenders to get the ball. It's very frustrating. That should have been us in front of this game. that was our moment. And I feel like we're probably going to end up losing now as a result of not putting our chances away. Just after I was saying that we're being so clinical. Well, clearly not that clinical, because we can't put penalties away. Right, that's just going to be mopped up here by Petkovic. Just lobbing it forward to Despotovic. He can win the knockdown, perhaps. He has Basancic. Maybe the ball over the top from Savicevic. No, he's taking it a little too short there. And, oh, wait. Basancic. There's not a lot of space in this. He's offside. He must be. Oh, he's at the crossbar. Oh, my God. Look at this. Four decent chances in this game, and we've not taken them. We're having a really good time here. In terms of in front of goal, we're creating some decent opportunities. They're shooting more, but it isn't making any difference, really. But we've got to be prepared for... Oh, Jesus. Okay. Oh. Okay, so... Thing is, we've got... where is he? Oh, he's not playing. Is he even on the bench? No. Great. Why do our defensive midfielders constantly get injured? Ah, Mihailovic. Oh, he's on the bench. Where is he? Ah, right, okay. Not great for the position, but it's got we've really got little choice in the matter. Where else should we bring someone on who's knackered? Lazic is looking a bit tired. As is Bosancic. But then we're lacking for the centre as well. So I think it's going to have to be Planic on for Darko Lazic. That's going to have to do for now. I might bring someone else. I might bring Strakulursi on for like the last 10 minutes just to try and nick something for us. But at the moment, I'm fairly... Well, that's what we pretty much got no choice in the matter. 25 minutes to go here. We are level on goals. So, you know, it's not... Oh, Jesus. We're level on the score sheet. Just don't let him knock it into this space. Don't let him knock... Oh! Fuck me. We... Why can't we finish like that? You could see it coming from a mile away. Oh, the composure, and it's a great finish, and the goalkeeper's just got no chance. So, here we go again. Christ, all aboard the bullshit train. Well, it's not bullshit, is it? We've just not... Oh, for God's sake. I'm so sick of the injuries on this game. I thought we were past this with injuries now, but it just seems that we get two or three of them every single game now. And it's getting a little bit stupid. Who can we bring on for Pasancic then? It's our last substitution, so basically no one. Savicevic can play there, but he's already on the pitch, so we've got no one to come in. I can bring on Pešnik to play in the centre. This is not going well, guys. Can't believe we're losing. I don't think we deserve to lose this with the way things have been going. Like, we've had some really good opportunities, we've just not put them in the net, and it's frustrating as hell. We may have to... I was going to say we may have to overload, but maybe not. If we can get ourselves level here, we may be able to be a bit more conservative for the last few minutes of this game. Jovanovic. Where's the ball? Oh, great. Antic. Keita, that's a good ball, actually. Oh, don't lose it. Mihailovic. Pešnik. Despotovic. Can he find a pass? He's offside. He's offside. Pešnik does good play. Lazovic. Can he knock it around the corner, perhaps? Out to Petkovic. Whipped all the way across and cleared. And we should win this back. What? No, he got the ball. Oh, for fuck. To me, he won the ball and got fouled, not the other way around. So, yeah, there we go. Another piece of crap. Well, so now we've got... Can Mihailovic play there? Probably not. No, he can. oh, fuck me. Well... It seems unlikely we're going to win this one now, does it? So injuries, suspensions, there's just... We're just getting everything. Oh, and Jagodina are also winning as well, which just makes it even worse. Get a foot in. He's just going to slide it into the channel and score. Oh, he's missed it. It's so easy for them, though. We're going to drop slightly deeper because they are getting in behind and we really have very little choice. But at the same time, I'm also going to overload because what hope have we really got? We've got... A draw would be, let me guess, go from a corner maybe to tie the game off with the perfect amount of, you're just never going to win this game in a million years. Ooh, What happened there? What the fuck happened there? He had the ball. You gotta laugh. I mean, I thought... So, the ball comes down here, and... What? He just ran right past it. And then they score. What do you want me to do? Like, you're going to send one player off, one misses a ball, three injuries. I give up. I can't bring anyone on. We've already made a lot of substitutions because of injuries and suspensions. Not suspensions, red cards. So he's... Unbelievable. Just unbelievable the amount of crap that's happened in this game. I'm at a loss, really, guys. I mean, we've not even been that bad. We've had four decent chances. They've had four decent chances. And yet, here we are. Lazovic. Pešnik is through here. Would he shoot? Lazovic? Nobody there. But then it's not really surprising we've got nobody there. We have no striker on the pitch because we have no ability to make a substitution in this game. Through there and through there and goal. Good save. I can't believe this. How are you? I mean, we were never going to win this game, were we? I mean, look at it. Everything that could go wrong basically has gone wrong. We've got three great players all out injured. One more is going to be suspended for the next game. I think we'll be lucky if we actually manage to win our next game because we're going to have so many players out injured. I'm just hoping that none of them are that serious. That's the only thing I can take. The problem is two of them were serious injuries. Although that doesn't always count as serious, does it? Because I've had players that have had to come off immediately injured, like throughout, with absolutely no choice to leave them on, and yet they've been completely fine for the next game. So I'm hoping we'll get a bit more of that. Markovic there, and I don't know what the keeper's doing, going out as far as that, but we shall see. Markovic knocks it through, and Kožić has again missed. I mean, they've had a load of chances late on, but like, what were we supposed to do? Most of our team is in. Are playing out of position. We've got no striker on the pitch, so we've got no forward outlet, really. I'm actually surprised they haven't managed to score another one. This game started so well. I remember me saying just before halftime, if we can get to halftime at 1-0, we might have a chance in this game. And then the game went, no. I think someone at SI might be a Partizan fan. That is quite some game. And I can't even say that they've played that badly. We've created a lot of decent chances in this game. It's just, oh, Christ on a bike. It's our first defeat since October. It's just the one game you wouldn't want it to happen in, but I just don't think that with the way things have happened in this game, any tactics I would have made wouldn't have prevented us from losing this game, I don't think, because of the amount of... That was basically what happened in the Boric game to us, except our goalkeeper was slower. And instead of trying to take a... The player didn't even take a touch. The keeper just ran straight past him. It was really bizarre. A bit like our player did there for their third goal, where he could have easily won the ball but decided to just walk past it and let them score instead. I think if you recall, that similar kind of thing happened to me in a game against Dortmund with the St. Pauli save last year, which I flipped because it was like the seventh or eighth goal they'd scored. We were unfortunate, but Jovanovic is going to be out, Bosančić is going to be out, Despotovic is going to be out, and I think there was another player that got injured in this game as well, Kovacevic. So there we have it. Does that back us down to fourth again? Yeah, we're back down to fourth, and now 3 points off the top with Jagodina. Bloody hell. That's all I can really say about that game. Bloody hell. I'm just going to go to the next screen so we can see how badly some of these players are injured. Because I'm praying that it's not too bad, because we've got Rad next, and that's going to be tough. They're a decent side. I just want to see how badly these injuries are going to affect us. We know that Jovanovic is going to be suspended, which is a pain, and I don't think it should have been sent off anyway, but... right, let's see. Karaman's back, that's definitely good. Oh, was it nine, man? No wonder we bloody lost. Of course, because we got a sending off, and then we got an injury, didn't we? Despotovic. Okay, so he's going to miss a game. Well, what more? I can't see what else we could have done. Our under-19s beat their under-19s, guys, so there's that. Jovanovic banned for one match. I'm not going to... fine him for that, just because Right, okay, good. So the only one that's actually serious is Despotov. I say it's serious. He's going to miss the next game, maybe two, which is a pain, but we'll make do with it. So yeah, there we go, guys. In our next game, we will be up against... Who will we be up against? We'll be doing Kukuriki, because there's still quite a few games left all of a sudden, because they seem to come thick and fast. So it'll be the Kukuriki game at home. So we've got Rad and we've got Borac. They're not going to be easy games. In fact, none of these are going to be easy games. Our sort of running is actually slightly more favourable. So we need to get good results from these games against Rad and Borac and Kukuriki. But I just can't believe it. Well, there you go, guys. If you like what you've seen, please feel free to drop a like on the episode. And if you'd like to even more than that, please feel free to subscribe to my channel for more Portsmouth and Sleeping Giants in your inbox every single day at 5:30 and 8 o'clock. And I will see you guys in the next episode. But until then, bye-bye.